This lesson is about transformers. No, not the shape-shifting robots. The transformers we're talking about today look more like this. We'll look at what transformers are, how they work, and calculate their effect using equations. We all know that we receive electricity from power plants. But as electricity makes the long journey from power plants to the plug in your home, there's a high potential for energy loss as heat. How can we prevent this? And we also know that power lines transport energy to our homes. But why are power lines dangerous, yet the electricity that enters our homes is safe to use? The answers to these questions come down to transformers, electrical devices that increase or decrease the voltage of an alternating current. Transformers look something like this. Two coils are wound around a soft metal core, usually iron, and one is connected to an alternating voltage source. That's the primary coil. The other coil, the secondary coil, is connected to the output. The AC supply in the primary coil generates a magnetic flux. The magnetic flux passes via the iron core through the secondary coil. According to Faraday's law, changing magnetic flux induces an electromotive force, or EMF, which induces a current in the circuit connected to the secondary coil. There are two main types of transformers, step up and step down. This one is a step up transformer, and we can tell because there are more turns in the secondary coil than in the primary. Power plants use step up transformers to increase voltage levels, so they're high enough to travel efficiency with minimal heat loss. Step down transformers have more turns in their primary coil, resulting in a lower voltage in the secondary coil. They reduce the voltage back down to safer levels before electricity enters your home. Now for some transformer equations. The EMF in a transformer's primary coil can be calculated with the following equation. Here, epsilon P is the EMF in the primary coil measured in volts. NP is the number of turns in the primary coil, and delta phi is the change in magnetic flux over time delta T. The loss in magnetic flux between the two coils is negligible, so we can take the equivalent equation for the secondary coil. All we've done is swap the EMF and number of turns in the primary coil for the EMF and number of turns in the secondary coil. Now, if we take that first equation and divide it by the second, cancelling out the change in magnetic flux, we can prove that the ratio of the EMFs between coils matches the ratio between the number of turns on the coils. Do not assume that the transformers can also work with a DC voltage source. They work based on changing magnetic flux, which can only be produced by an AC source. Let's apply our equation in an example. Suppose we have an EMF of 120 volts and need to convert it to an EMF of 8 volts. Our transformer has 300 turns in the primary coil. How many turns should the secondary coil have to obtain the desired voltage? Pause the video now if you want to try the calculation before seeing the solution. Our equation can be rewritten as: substitute in the values we already know, the input and output voltage and the number of turns in the primary coil. And there's your answer. There should be 20 coils in the secondary coil of this step-down transformer to achieve the desired output. In this video, we learned what a transformer is, the two main types, and how to apply transformer equations. That's it for today. Thanks for watching.